£1,000 from Queen's Park Rangers during the summer, and who injured his back one day before the season opened, now makes his first appearance for his new club in this Crystal Palace side that also has Vince Hilaire recovered from flu and now wearing the number 11 shirt. Billy Gilbert at 6 was in the England under 21 side in Norway on Tuesday, and Ian Walsh came on as a sub for Wales in Czechoslovakia on Wednesday, and Billy Hughes, signed in the summer from Gillingham, is the Palace substitute. And as we look at the Charlton side, by a coincidence, the man that Ian Walsh replaced in the Welsh side on Wednesday night, Leighton Phillips, wears the number 6 shirt for the visitors today. But the bad news for Charlton is that Steve Gritt and Paul Walsh are both out injured. 17-year-old Paul Elliott is in defence now. He captained the England youth side in Yugoslavia this week. And Martin Robinson takes Walsh's place. The referee today is Cliff Maskell of Cambridge. And it's Crystal Palace who get us away in the strip of white, attacking the goal to our left. Charlton in an all-red strip. On a day really when professional footballers everywhere, whether they're playing in the first, second, third or fourth divisions, should be doing something to repair morale, I think, that suffered so much in Oslo on Wednesday. Curious footwear there of Derek Hales. He's got some padding around his ankles, which may be symptomatic of some of the challenges he expects to get in the course of a game. Side of the back four. Here's Smillie, very mobile player. And a foul there by Phil Walker. And the referee coming across straight away to have a word with him for the challenge on Jim Cannon. My feeling was that it looked worse than it was. And my impression over the last few seasons is that Phil Walker is not quite that sort of player. But a free kick quite properly given. Cannon with a long ball there again towards Wicks on the far side. Got the header in. Just wide there, as Hinshelwood was right in there looking for something for Crystal Palace. And in his first game, Wicks really looks as though he might be a threat in the air for Charlton. It's Smillie then with the corner. Played in too low that time, and Hales getting that away quite comfortably from the near post. Bason finding Smillie again. Might be enough start here. Certainly Wicks with his power in the air was a problem there for Charlton, and Hinshelwood couldn't quite get a header in, and a corner resulted. Pump in the back on Hales by Steve Wicks, and a free kick to Charlton. It's already taken, not from the exact spot there by Leighton Phillips. Harrison playing it on for Hales again. Oh, he dummied Gilbert well there, and showed the power of the man and the danger, Hales, because there looked to be none, and suddenly there was, until Barron got his fist to it, and now it's a free kick for Crystal Palace for the foul on Vince Hilaire. The threat of Hales, his strength, and the difficulty defenders have in budging him off the ball were all shown to good effect there just a moment ago. And here's Walker. Ferns played in again for Walker, but he was a little too slow there and gave Gilbert every chance of getting in and making the challenge. Mullery there in the director's box next to his chairman, Michael Brixton of Charlton. Phil Walker. And out here there. Oh, and two players down there in some distress after that clash. Paul Hinshelwood is one, and I think Don McAllister the other. And that was the clash. And the stretcher coming on for McAllister. And I think Alan Mullery just trying to reorganise things a little bit just to see how bad McAllister is. And so Don McAllister, who clearly is badly knocked about the face, on the back of the head, by the way, he's feeling gingerly in that area, goes off for some treatment. And Kevin Dickenson, young former Spurs fullback, warms up, wondering if he's going to get a chance. Here's Hilaire. In again for Walsh. Lansdowne. Now Hilaire again. Beautiful little bit of skill there. Close control by Hilaire, then he tried just a little too much against Ferns, and a chance for Robinson to break. Hinshelwood going, he's beaten them all now. Wicks is covering up, Ferns has gone streaking through the middle, Hales is in there too, and if it comes to Hales, it's got to be a goal! And it's saved superbly by Barron. Well, I tell you, 99 times out of 100, you would have had to put Hales, the scorer, down for that one. He very rarely misses opportunities like that. But that was a golden chance for Hales, and Barron foiled him superbly. Well, that's quite remarkable with Derek Hales. Only Stuart Leary has scored more goals for Charlton than this fella here. He scored 120 goals for Charlton in the League and Cup in two spells with the club. And he scored some, and he usually makes sure of them in that sort of position. Still playing with 10 men, with McAllister off the field, and Barron, oh, that looked very catchable, but he decided on the punch. Harrison playing it back, Walker playing it on, Hales trying to get inside, but the flag was up, and I must say my impression was that he was level with the last defender. Langley. Oh, that's played in there by Naylor for Walsh. Scorching goal. The ball played in there, and once it had been played in there by the Charlton defence, past the despairing dive of Nicky Johns. And Palace go ahead, Ian Walsh. Now Smillie. Here's Langley. Elliott coming across to cover. Playing it back to Nicky Johns, who certainly had no chance with that ferocious drive from the Welsh international. Nice. And then McAllister, who's had four stitches in a head wound, is coming back onto the field of play and thoroughly deserving the round of applause he's got from the crowd. Here's Elliott, played a little dangerously there, and Phillips in trouble, and the whistle had gone just when Palace were about to pounce, and Bason was there on the edge of the box, and again, for the second time in a matter of a minute, there's been the most awful confusion in that Charlton defence. Walsh has gone into the wall to add a certain confusion. Smiley might well just touch it off. Phillips maybe to have a crack, no. It's Hinshelwood turning it and turned away well by Nicky Johns. Well taken free kick, well worked, beautifully executed. The little touch by Smiley for Hinshelwood. Curled round the wall as the man in the wall from Palace had moved away, and Nicky Johns turning it away for the corner. Very well worked free kick indeed, and here's a long, long corner towards Steve Wicks. Gets the header in well. Jim Cannon's there also. Smiley looking for something on the volley. Tommy Langley trying an overhead, and Nicky Johns in the end gathering it at the highest point. And while ructions breaking out there, as Walsh and Nicky Johns got involved, and suddenly the Charlton defence closed in on the Palace player. As they went, I feel, genuinely for the ball, but the temperature rose rapidly and it needed to be cooled down quickly there by referee Maskell. Having a word, first of all, I think, with Terry Naylor, who's certainly been in there at the protection of his goalkeeper. There may have been one or two elbows there as we look around it, but it was an amazing run. Well, yes, there may have been an elbow by Walsh on Nicky Johns. And that's when the fun started. Half-time whistle, and Palace lead by a goal to nil. Their only goals this season have been for penalties, two of them by Paul Hinshelwood, but that's the first genuine goal, if you like, of the season. scored by Ian Walsh with that flashing drive after 23 minutes, after Derek Hales uncharacteristically had missed what for him was certainly a golden opportunity to put Charlton into the lead. Welcome back then, as Charlton get us away at the start of the second half. Attacking the goal to our left, a goal down scored by Ian Walsh for Crystal Palace. Of course, two divisions separated these neighbours last season. Palace, who were relegated from the first, with only 19 points for the whole season. They won only six league games. Charlton, who came up from the third, with a very creditable 59 points. But here they are together in the second division, separated by Ian Walsh's goal. Hassan having that pass quite easily cut out by Paul Elliott. Played here for Phil Ferns. Here's Phil Walker. And a free kick to Charlton for the foul on Walker. Don McAllister with quite a nasty wound on the back of his head, with four, behind his right ear, in fact, with four stitches in it. Fans would see him in a slightly different role today, more as an anchor man in midfield than as a back four defender, which he was so often at White Hart Lane. David Price getting that one away for Palace. Lansdowne, a little touch for Walker. And Hilaire getting it away, but the header goes straight to Ferns, who drives one wide of the Palace goal. Space here for Bason. Curling one in there for Tommy Lane. Here's Hilaire. Harrison pulling it away, and there was a little bit of pushing there by Hilaire, quickly spotted by the referee, giving Charlton the free kick. So it'll be Steve Harrison and Nicky Johns between them. Coming in early towards the near post, Walsh had made a run in the right direction, but it came a little too strongly for him. Walsh for Bason. Mitchell. Cut out by Lansdowne. Cannon was back at him. Here's Smillie. Got the pace to beat Naylor. He has. Walsh with a header! Beautiful goal! Smiley's cross was perfection. But that was a good strike by the Welsh international, Ian Walsh. Because he came in on it superbly and guided it perfectly there, just inside the post. His second goal and Palace's, with coming up to 6 minutes of the second half goal. Robinson. Naylor making a break from the back, but he's only got Hales up. Might be enough, but he's got others coming up, like Robinson and... A terrible miskick there by Robinson, which in its turn took McAllister by surprise. And really, McAllister had no time to readjust and to get in a worthwhile shot himself. But it was a great break by Terry Naylor. You have to give him credit for that. And a lovely pullback. And suddenly there were red shirts everywhere. Complete miskick by Martin Robinson over the top. Ferns at the moment looking the more accomplished side, it's to be said, but Charlton just every so often having these little stabbing attacks that threaten in the same way there. Now McAllister has to go into the book for that. Challenge and an unfair one on the back of Vince Hilaire. McAllister may be suggesting that Hilaire is making more of it than it required. But equally, there are plenty of people in the game who feel that players of skill have to be protected, as Mr. Maskell has protected Hilaire there. Another free kick then for Palace, and it's going to be Gilbert in it. Good safe catch by Nicky Johns. Down he went under a challenge from somebody. Was it Hinshelwood or was it Walsh? They were both in there. Hinshelwood, I think, but he's all right to go. Phillips, a long ball forward, and a good chase by McAllister now. Has he got the pace to get there? He has. And he's just missed what would have been a sensational goal. Who has always been good coming up for set pieces, but suddenly what a galloping run from the midfield it was, and he outstripped the ball, and his nerve held well, his persistence was almost rewarded as Barron came out, and look how close that was to being a really fine goal. And here's Hinshelwood crossing in again. Walsh trying to get up there. Price with a header, cannon against McAllister. Hit first time there, Wicks. Wide for Smillie. Little period, this. A lot of skillful football at the moment. And Langley trying to get in there, but that was a good header away by Phillips. No foul, good decision by the referee. The game got a nice momentum at the moment as Hinshelwood takes it in, then misses his kick completely. Phillips trying to get away. Price should get in there, does find Smillie. And the little cross there, not quite reaching Langley. Price again. Hitting one straight at Hinshelwood, who was just back in an onside position. Remarkable, good cross coming in, and in the end, it's Elliott who had to get it away. Well, that was a really entertaining minute or so of football, with a ball buzzing around that Charlton penalty area, and always it seemed possible that someone might just find the finishing touch. They never quite did, but Palace have got a corner, leading by 2-0, with a quarter of an hour remaining. Lansdowne's header. Free kick. Deliberate pulling back there by Hinshelwood on Phil Ferns. Derek Hales. And he really clattered that one, but he hit it straight at the Palace defender. And Paul Hinshelwood putting it again into the crowd. Last minute of the game. Towards the near post, Robinson is there, glancing it back there. Lansdowne tried, could have been an overhead, but it's quite a useful game, Billy Lansdowne. Very few opportunities at Upton Park in the West Ham first team. I saw him get a hat-trick, though, in a League Cup tie against Southend two or three seasons ago. For Hilaire, under pressure from McAllister. And the final whistle, and a victory for Crystal Palace, with Ian Walsh getting two fine goals, a great drive and a beautifully placed header, and Palace looking the more fluent, the more skillful side, deserving their victory against a Charlton team. Well, two Welsh internationals who were in Czechoslovakia together there, Leighton Phillips on the left and Ian Walsh. who in fact, and I think the crowd of just over 14,000 would feel that Charlton, with a number of new faces in their side, just as yet haven't quite got their act together. Final score then here at Selhurst Park. Crystal Palace 2, Charlton Athletic 0.